But there are so many times in our lives where we set out this goal and we start to walk on the path to that goal. And circumstance causes us to have to adjust. We have to pivot. We have to make changes on the fly. And myself included, we can use those in two different ways. We could use those as detractors, or we could use those as lessons. We could use those as opportunities to grow or opportunities to stumble. Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Vinny Brusco Show podcast. Hope you're enjoying the podcast. If you are, do me a favor, of course, spread the word, tell a friend, but also please subscribe to the podcast down below. It means a lot. It helps with all the algorithm and all that shit I really don't understand, but it will help grow the show and bring more awareness to the show. So if you could do that, it'd be greatly, greatly appreciated. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed this solo episode of the Vinny Brusco Show podcast. Enjoy.
And here we go.
A few weeks ago, I went away with my family. And prior to that, I have been doing some trail running. I don't know why. I saw a trail on the side of the highway. I thought to myself, I think I want to run that trail. And I did. I started running the trail. And the minute I stepped on the trail, I knew that this was something different. I am not a big fan of running. I never have been. I am now. But I always thought running, you had to be like the fastest. You know, you had to beat everybody. And the minute I stepped on that trail and I started doing this trail running, I realized that it's this moving meditation. It's these moments where you can have some clarity in your mind. Although you're moving, there's this stillness that kind of can poke its head through, and it's very, very meditative. And I'm a huge, huge advocate of anything that makes me feel like a child again. So running through the woods and just that freedom almost is very intoxicating to me. And I've also come to realize that I like anything that will allow me to go down rabbit holes, jujitsu, running now, you know, thought, meditation, float tanks. These are all things that allow me to go on this endless search and this endless trail of discovery. And I'm very drawn to it. So I started trail running, and I've been doing at least a trail once a week, at least 5 miles. And we went to the shore and there were no trails. So I figured, all right, well, I could run the beach. It's like the trail. A lot harder. I wouldn't say a lot harder, but it's harder. It's different kind of harder, but it's hard. It's fucking hard either way. And I went out one morning and I set out a goal of 2.7 miles in and 2.7 miles out. So 5 miles pretty much. And that's my breaking point. Like I can get 5 miles done in an hour to 12-minute mile. It's nothing to write home about, but I can get to 5 miles and I feel like I'm going to die, but I don't die. I'm like right there. So I went out and started running. I noticed as I was running, you know, I hit that little bit of runner's flow, you know, I hit a little bit of that flow state, and I kept on setting these markers on the beach that were going to be my next goal, like my little micro goal. And as I turned this one bend, far in the distance is this lighthouse. And I thought to myself, well, that's going to be the goal. That's where I'm going. And in my mind, I was like, once I cross the lighthouse, I'll run through it. There'll be a ribbon. I'll burst through the ribbon. Someone will come give me flowers and put a medal. And none of that happened, obviously. But in my mind, that was the goal. That's where I was going. And I was intermittently just like kind of checking my watch and seeing. And I was clearly going over the 2.7 miles that I set out in my mind originally. And I kept on going. And the lighthouse seemed like it was just forever away. And I was just still going towards it. And I finally got to the lighthouse. And there was no flowers, there was no medal, there was no ribbon to cross. But I did have this sense of accomplishment. And the thing I hated about running was once you run, you got to run back. It's not like you just hop off the treadmill and you're done. Like, no, now you got to go back. So I started my journey back to where I started. And I started thinking about a few different things. And one thing that came up in my mind was the idea of greatness. And how do we actually become great? And what is being great? You know, there are great athletes and writers and podcasters and actors and actresses. And how do we define greatness within ourselves? And in that moment, when I was thinking about my own personal greatness, I stopped and asked myself, well, what would the greatest version of myself be doing right now? And thankfully, what came back to me was what I'm doing, running. That's what the greatest version of me would be doing right now. He would be running. So therefore, I am embodying the greatest version of myself. And I thought to myself how I set out this goal of 2.7 miles and 2.7 miles, 5 miles plus, but I was clearly going to go past that just based off of where I went to on the lighthouse. And now I have to go back. I was clearly going to surpass that. And I was thinking to myself, if I would have just succumbed to the idea of doing 5 miles in or 5 miles total, I wouldn't go any further. Now I had to adjust my mindset on the run because I was getting tired and the knee and my ankle. And I'm like, all right, this is God. Now I'm getting a little rickety here and all the little quirks and quarrels and nooks and crannies started coming up. And all right, like I kept on having to push those thoughts to the back of my mind and be like, all right, well, that's not what we're focusing on. We're just focusing on running right now. That's all that's in front of you is just the running. And if I would have just succumbed to those, I might have not accomplished my goal. I might have not even gotten to the 5 miles. I certainly would have gotten to the 7.37 that I ended up doing. But there are so many times in our lives where we set out this goal and we start to walk on the path of that goal. And circumstance causes us to have to adjust. We have to pivot. We have to make changes on the fly. And myself included, we could use those in two different ways. We could use those as detractors, or we could use those as lessons. We could use those as opportunities to grow or opportunities to stumble. And sitting on this run and sitting in my space, in my headspace, and just embracing the run, embracing the journey of the run, allowing myself to have those thoughts come up. Like, oh, this sucks, whatever. Okay, you're hot. It's tiring. Okay. But then allowing those to also now take a back seat, not identifying in any one of those. And when I was able to ask myself, what is the greatest version of you doing right now? And the answer came back as you're running. I felt like I'm embodying this best version of me right now. And it's not to take away from my wife or my kids or my family or anybody, but in this moment right now, I was in a space of optimization. I was embodying who I ultimately want to be. And it's through hard work. It's through running. It's through setting these small micro goals that ultimately are not the main goal. So the main goal wasn't 5 miles. The main goal wasn't the lighthouse. The main goal wasn't the lifeguard chair. The main goal was to find and embrace the journey towards that, to find and embrace the run itself, and to pivot and to adjust and to sit in a space of discomfort. And so many times we get caught up in the goal. And if it's not the goal that we want, we think that we're automatically on the wrong path. By automatically defaulting to that, by automatically defaulting to the negative mindset, by not creating a harmonious internal dialogue within ourselves. And that creates us and causes us to not take action, to not embrace the next step, to not adjust the goal. And setting the goal is one thing, so important, but it's the journey towards that goal, towards that lighthouse, is where we learn all of it. I got past the lighthouse and I went another few feet or whatever it was, and that was it. Nothing special. I had to turn around and go back. And had I had just went with my initial plan, I would have stopped at 5 miles, but I ended up doing 7.37 miles, which to some people, that's nothing. That's a blip to some people. To some people, that's insurmountable. To me, wasn't my best, wasn't my worst. It elevated me. It challenged me. Jumped in the ocean right afterwards and it felt fan-fucking-tastic. But it got me thinking that we always have an opportunity to ask ourselves in any given moment, is this an embodiment? Am I embodying the best version of myself right now? And if the answer is no, that's okay. You don't have to beat yourself up about it. You have to kick yourself and like, ah, I suck, this sucks, I suck. You don't have to go down that road. You could stop in that moment and say, okay, well, what would the best version of me be doing right now? Will they be doing this? Okay. And then go back to the laboratory of yourself and see how you can take that information and use it for your goals, reassessment. How can you apply that into your everyday life, into an accountability and disciplined mindset to help you achieve your goals, to go past what you thought you could do, to be the greatest version of yourself? So that's what I leave you with today. In any given moment, ask yourself, am I embodying the best version of myself? And if the answer is no, that's okay. But what can you do to change that? Because the next time you ask yourself, hopefully, the The answer will be yes. That is it. I will check you guys out next time. Until then, much love. Peace.